not even cleaning up.
I'm going to take him up one on this side.
I know there's a difference in the truck.
Look
how nicely he does it, though.
Oh, these are people horses.
Hello. Say hi to the camera, Lightning. Ready?
Come on, make him fart for us. That's Lightning's special gift.
What does that mean, Mark?
Boy, this is so much easier than bareback.
No, we're not gonna trot. I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
Is that what you say when he trots, to get him to trot? You say, "We're not gonna trot," and then I don't know much about this horse stuff.
Yeah, how do you get him?
You go, "We're not gonna trot," and then they take right off.
Lightning likes to trot. Lightning is very easy to get.
He loves to trot. So how do you get him not to trot?
You say, "Let's trot."
Let's try.
So they know by your, as you're pulling the rein.
Okay, so you adjust.
They're pretty smart. They really take commands. They're trained.
Just like a dog.
They're not really trained. Because they're not trained.
Come on, I got a favor. I gotta get rid of my gun. Oops, pick it up, sweeties. Or don't leave it buried.
Mark, take the gum out of the horse's mouth, too.
Okay.
Oh, Mark, it's right
there.
You're rough.
It should be right here.
Now, English reins.
It should be right here. Isn't that it? Look, right here. Right where my foot.
Don't step on me, Wim. I'm just not in the mood. Okay, then you can ask yourself right in the trunk.
So now this is the beauty. This is the beauty of an English
smart.
You can lower your hand to where
you got the back to get on all by yourself. We're not trotting. That was a
thing.
How about that? Come down a couple more.
He's one of the fetish on the sparrows.
All I'm going to put some pressure in this stirrup.
Now watch this.
You got hair?
No.
You reach hair?
What are the sides? One of these things.
One of these things. That's push against the stirrup stuff. Slide. And hold it.
He can't reach his hair.
Okay, grip. Pull yourself up.
Flip.
No, the saddle's not going anywhere. The saddle's not
pushing on against the stirrup step. Think of it as a giant step. There you go.
Whoa.
All right. Hold on to it.
Whoa.
Quickie. It's not time.
Whoa.
Whoa. Stop.
Whoa.
Okay.
Whoa.
Okay. English stirrups. A whole lot different. Remember how we judged when it was the proper length for you? Stood up. Did you fall down?
No.
Okay. Get your foot down here. The English stirrup, the bottom of the... I know you want to go, son, but
stop it.
The English stirrup must hit you. Here's your ankle. Okay? That's where that needs to be. Now, the nice thing about it is you can adjust your stirrups while you're sitting beside them. Okay? Well, you couldn't really do it that well with English, or with a Western style.
You want to jump.
Now, what happens if you run out of holes on your English stirrup? Okay, what if you're really too short for the amount of leather that you have? It's nice because you can always wrap the stirrup. You take it apart from the buckle, you wrap this around a couple of times on the stirrup iron, and then buckle. So if you've got a real short bit, you know, you're not going to be, remember right in bareback where your knees were?
Not up here.
No, that was an experiment for showing you.